Jim Hoagland, contributing editor to the Washington Post and a Pulitzer Prize winner. Jim, you're American. What do you think the impact of President Trump has been and will be on the rest of the world and also on America?
We have the weakest president in modern times in America at a time when in Russia and particularly in China, you have the strongest leader in recent times. It diminishes American leadership in the world to have a president who is so impulsive and undisciplined and who pays so little attention to the rest of the world.
Do you think that's dangerous to the rest of the world?
I think it's quite dangerous. I think it's dangerous most of all for the United States in that we no longer have a clear vision of what our role in the world is beyond whatever it is that strikes the president's attention at any given moment. And it leads us to question the role of American leadership in the world.
What do you think it means for multilateral institutions that, after America was the prime mover in setting up after the Second World War?
It means that we have to look for ways to rebuild this global community that had grown up in the ruins after World War II. And we have to find ways to work more closely with other countries against this president's will. And that is a very difficult.
I mean, one of the things that this president has done has been to refuse to recertify the Iran nuclear deal, to hand it over to Congress. What is the message that sends to everybody?
I think it's a very dangerous message in terms of the rest of the world's appreciation of what America can and should be doing on a real crisis. Iran represents a serious problem for the international community, not just for the United States. But to take an action to diminish this agreement, which our partners, our closest diplomatic partners, have worked with us to achieve, and just to take a unilateral approach is, I find, very disturbing.
Jim, a final question. It's clear that you're not a fan of President Trump.
And vice versa, I must say.
Clearly. Will he be reelected?
I think you have to look at three possibilities for Trump at this point. One is a kind of collapse in which he's no longer capable of carrying out the duties of office. Two is impeachment. I think that's a very remote possibility for a lot of complicated constitutional reasons. Or three, he's reelected. We can no longer, alas, exclude that option.
Jim, thank you very much.
John, thank you.